Hello, my name is Jacob Mattioli, the owner, founder, and creator of JE Studio Sports Productions NC, and I'm proud to present my top 10 App State moments ever in the last few years. First, let me get started thanking App State TV for use their videos. So I have to thank them. I'd like to thank Dave Jackson for that, and I'd like to thank Scott Satterfield, Jerry Moore, Mark Cox, a lot of the players, and the High Country Grizzlies. I'd like to thank all these people for just at least talking to me and giving me inspiration and telling me what to do. I have a lot of fans and stuff out there. Not really a lot, but I still have fans out there. Thank you very much, fans, if you follow me. But let's get started. I want to show you my motivational speech that I created yesterday, one day project, out of App State videos. Thank you very much for those YouTube videos. Thank you very much. But one day, here we go, motivational speech. Hit it, boys.
It's more than just a game. It's everything. What is your why? Why do you play this game? Why do you love this game? Why will you fight and die for this game? Is it for the championship? Is it for your teammates? Is it for your coaches? Is it for those fans who back you day after day? You are prepared for this game. You know what the other team is doing. You know the game plan. We put the hard work in all year. Now it's time to grind. Now it's time to shine. When you're walking down that tunnel, if you're not going out there to win, don't go out there. You've been waiting your entire life for this moment. And now that it's here, let's show the world we are prepared. We are prepared for war. We are prepared for battle. We are prepared for the enemy on the other side of the field. It doesn't matter who we face. We will fight. We will grind. We will dominate, and we will win. We will win this championship. You've been working. You've been working. And you've been working to defeat them, to destroy them. So don't show any weakness. Don't show any pain. Don't even feel any pain. Now is the time to let them know we will be victors. No one will get in the way of this victory. Brothers, together, I fight for you. You fight for me. Together, we fight to win. I'm looking for someone that would dare try to stop me. No one can stop me. No one can stop my team. No team will stop us if we stand together. All the hard work we put in will show on the field. The field of battle. Let's go win this championship.
We got lots of gas, we gon' blow it. Move a lot of weight, yeah, we gon' show it. We just took your, oh yeah, she gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, if you can't see behind me, this is Coach Jerry Moore. We're going to count down our top 10 players, moments, and memories of App State history. I know this may be out order for you guys, but these are my top 10, in my opinion, for App State. Number 10. Two top coaches I ever believe we ever had, besides Sparky Woods, which is a great coach, Jerry Moore, and we have Scott Satterfield. Two best coaches I think we had in App in a long time. Just want to thank those coaches and say Some of them really nice. So here's a little video montage of a couple of them. Here, boys. Thank you. Now, we look behind. We get to talk about, right here, this guy right here, Jay Moore, football consultant for the High Country Grizzlies, one of the best arena football teams, new coming teams in the league for the National Arena League. Plays in the home competition center. Next home game is in a couple weeks against the Georgia Firebirds, I believe. They beat Georgia Firebirds for the first ever franchise win in the first ever game. So, let's go Grizzlies. Malachi Jones, Dexter Jackson, a lot of app players are on that team. We got some good players, and don't forget about Wrecking Ball Hendricks. Let's talk about Scott Satterfield. Scott Satterfield here, he has won two, and I repeat, two Camellia Bowl championships back-to-back, beating Toledo in Ohio. These two teams were powerhouses those 2 years that we played them, and App just took on the challenge. I'm proud to announce Appalachian State. I thank you, Scott Satterfield, for your time, and I hope if you move on somewhere else someday, you have a great transition there. But for now, keep on waiting for App. Okay, now we get to number 9. You can't really see that. Number 9 is a player that we all know and love wearing 14. We have two 14s in this video. You may know one already from the NFL, already in the NFL. Now kind of slowing down. He's been traveling around a little bit, but he plays for the Carolina Panthers, Chicago Bears, and Saskatchewan, I believe, the teams he played for, big teams, and it is Armani Edwards, number 9. Ladies and gentlemen, Armani Edwards is one of the best quarterbacks App has ever had, and I'm just so thrilled when I got to meet him. Do I have my little paper here? I don't think I do.
Yeah.
But I actually have this right here. I can get my light. You can see it is App. It's a real jersey from Armani Edwards. I had something signed by him if I can't find it right now. But let's watch a video of his best play in the NFL for the Carolina Panthers. 82-yard reception against the Washington Redskins. Hit it, boys.
With Stewart in the backfield. Newton out of the shotgun. Fakes the handoff to Stewart. Newton fires downfield and the catch is made by Armani Edwards. And Edwards, with one man to beat, is knocked down by that Redskin defender, Cedric Griffin.
Watch the help right here. It's going to be a max protection. Get in there. If anybody needs a little bit of help, get them pushed around. Cam stands in the pocket and just hits this in stride.
Steve Smith coming from the other side of the field. Look at this block right here to go and get him another 25, 30 yards. Great hustle by Steve Smith.
Number 8. Number 14, right now, just graduated this year, it is Marcus Cox. Marcus Cox is all-time rusher, I believe. I'm not sure. There's a lot of confusion there for me for some reason. But
number one.
Leading rusher for Appalachian State in history, and I'm proud to say he's a good player. He's a great person, and I hope he does well in the NFL. Houston's looking at him right now, I heard, so hopefully he'll get drafted. But he is definitely a prospect to look at. He may be a little undersized and stuff, but he is definitely a man to look at. Let's watch a little senior highlight reel and stuff from Marcus Cox. Let's go.
Yeah. Hey. Hey.
14, the man who is very likely to lead this university as the most prolific runner in its history.
But I took it, they ain't give it to me. She really do it to me.
And he's the all-time leading rusher in Appalachian State football history.
I started hooping for the Nike check. I play tennis for the Rolex.
Cox throwing it running back. Gets the handoff, running left. Steps it outside to the 35. Stays on his feet, 30. Marcus Cox breaking away to the 10, to the 5. Cox to the end zone. That's an out-state touchdown for Marcus Cox.
I just didn't get no picks up. You was there, shit. You saw me get my shit up. Oh, you heard about it.
Reaction by Lamb. Got to throw it back to the other side. And caught by Cox. It looks. Dives in zone.
I really got it, ain't no secret to it. If I did it, then I had to do it. She really dope, she really got it. I had to
Lamb,
do it.
That's a really late pick. Cox, touchdown!
Really dope, I really got it, ain't no secret to it.
That's gotta feel
if
good
did
for the
it,
senior.
Then I had to do it. She really dope, she really got it. Yeah. I had to do it, she can't go. Damn, I love it when they get it. She know
he
I got it.
From the critic in the Senate. Invite her over. Score.
I ain't expect shit. The alcohol for touchdown, dinner, turn the gun for breakfast. Cox. Exit stage left on some clever shit. Like, gotta pick up my pops from the airport and shit. White lies and shit. Told y'all I ain't shit. I'm Federer with the serve. Kershaw with the curve.
Tony shotgun gets to Cox. Running outside right. Cuts inside at the 8. Hit at the 7. Stays on his feet to the 5. All the way to the end zone. And he is in. That's an App State touchdown for Marcus Cox. A brutalizing touchdown run. His third of the day for the senior. Hold on, option up, pitch to Cox quickly across the 25-yard marker, 35-40, left sideline midfield, breaking tackles all the way down to the 35-yard line and drag down there. Another big run for the App State offense.
Damn, it's muscle memory to us now. Before I was up, I had
shotgun,
to stay
gets to
down.
Cox running right, yeah. Makes a tackle to the 50. Now the 45, Marcus breaks now. Away to the 35 to 30. Down the right sideline, foot race. Marcus now. Cox with a stiff arm as
really
he barrels down at the 5.
Really got it. Ain't no
let's see now how App State rebounds. Here's Cox.
Really
and Cox
really
has running room
it.
Past the 30-yard line. Cox is free. Trying to outrun the cage.
I really got it. No
he will!
It, to
touchdown
really
Appalachian
do.
State!
She really got it. I had to do it. She came through.
And this one may surprise a lot of people. It is number 7 on my list, but these three go down the order. You may say, why are these not top? You'll see later why they're not my top. Because 2011, 2010 was the first time I ever started getting the football, so I wasn't really a big fan when the three championships happened. But I watched the videos over and over again, but I definitely think this one deserves number 7 spot. 2006 championship against
UMass,
I believe. Was that either UMass or... Yeah, it was UMass, I believe. Sorry, folks. This is my first ever podcast, too, so just bear with me. 2006 championship. Against UMass. This was a close one. I watched the video, watched the film, but let's watch a quick highlight reel of it before we go on to number 6.
We'll be right back.
I think this deserves this spot really well. You guys may disagree with this, but 2007 championship. I think this deserves the number 6 spot really well because there's some stuff from this past year I rate really highly. But we all know what's number 1. You can guess it coming up. But I'm going to just say 2006, 3 national championships, I think you all know what's going to come before 2007, I mean. But I think this deserves it because it's our last championship, but it's not, but our first one, I feel like it's more better. It's our first one ever. You know how exciting that is. But let's watch a short highlight reel. Here, number five, I get the 2005 championship, the first ever championship we won. My dad won all three championships, and he was really happy and stuff, but at that time I was like, okay, I was just a kid. But now I look back on it, I think number five deserves, 2005 deserves number five, because of the way it was the first championship ever, and we went back to back to back, so I feel like it went in that order perfectly. It went from, like, down that row. I think If you could erase one championship, and, like, not erase it, but, like, doesn't count as much, I would say it would be 2006.
Because that was in the middle.
Like, no, it was a big game. Don't get me wrong. I still love that game, but it was still in the middle for me. I don't really consider that one the best. I consider 2007 our last one and 2005 our first one to be our best one. But, yeah, that's definitely what it was. Let's go on to number four. But first, let's watch a short thing, I believe, that was the final score of the game on defense. Jason Hunter.
Second down and nine. Sanders to throw. And the ball's out! And it's picked up by Hunter! Jason Hunter, touchdown, Appalachian State! An unbelievable shift in momentum here in Chattanooga in the national title game.
And Jason Hunter has been the most dominant player on the field tonight. That ball just slips out, and he's in the right spot with his great speed to get the touchdown.
That is Hunter's third touchdown of the season. We do have instant replay, but it doesn't matter now. And the extra point is good. Jason Hunter and Marcus Morrell have both been spectacular. Hunter, great play just to scoop it up. And then he storms into the end zone to give the Mountaineers a 5-point lead.
Number four.
You can hear it rain outside, folks. I'm sorry, I'm in my room. This is my room. But number four, guys, goes to the 2016 Sunbelt Conference champion, the Mountaineers of Appalachian State. This moment goes down to my number four spot. That's one of my favorite moments of all time. I was psyched when Arkansas State didn't get that touchdown. I watched that game. I was hyped. I was, like, scared. Every emotion you could feel when we won that championship. And I know our players were psyched, too. First ever championship. And I just can't believe it. But I have a reason behind why this is my number. You can see our championship wall right here in the app. Athletics. You'll see why I put this in number four and not low.
Deep territory. I don't think anyone saw that coming, and Critcher makes a huge play.
It's time to buy back the hood. Buy back the hood. I'm about to buy back the hood. Buy back the hood. It's time to clean up the ghetto. A dope boy wanna shine. Time to buy back the block. Talking one brick at a time. I sold a few records. I bought me a Checkers. Swing stock well invested, so Taco Bell left for breakfast. I seen a few M's. It's time to touch me that 100. So let
what y'all been able to do is miraculous, man. They make movies about this kind of stuff right here, man. The 2016 Sun Belt Champion!
Number three, top three here. It is 2016 Camellia Bowl Championship. Wait, you may be wondering, why is this back here? This should be in front of 2015. Well, no. I think the first one's always better than the second one. Because if you can look at all the stats and everything, we led in the game against Toledo, everything. Camellia Bowl was like, I think in championships and bowl games, it's all the same. If you go, the first win's always memorable. But after you win a couple, it's going to be, we're great, we know. But the first one's always memorable. So, I put this in my number three spot. But let's watch a quick, I think I have a quick highlight reel of this. So, let's watch it right quick.
Samuel Vucelic going to kick it away into the wind to Darrington Evans. This is going to be returnable. Very short kick that bounces right into Evans' breadbasket from the 7-yard line. Crosses the 20, breaks the tackle, 25.
Go, 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 go.
And there goes Evans across the 35 and 40. Foot race down the sidelines. Evans breaks a tackle. He will take it the distance for an App State touchdown.
Oh, that was so good. That was so good, baby. That was so good.
Short kick, fields it off the hop. Evans breaks free, the 50, tripped up, he's still on his feet. He's gonna go. 94 yards, no flags, touchdown App State.
On behalf of Raycon, congratulations. I mean, you guys have a pretty good ball record. Undefeated.
Now this one I gave a hint to, it is a 2015 Camellia Bowl Championship. Now I ranked this in number two because it's just like a championship. I mean, I became a football fan in like 2011. This is like a first ever big thing we won. So I was like, I went to both Camellia Bowls, so I experienced them both. But the 2015 one, it was every emotion. I mean, I loved it. It was great. I just enjoyed it so much. I mean, I can't explain how happy I was when I saw us win, but I know Coach Scott Satterfield was even happier. But let me just explain something to you. I think the first one's always best, like I said before, but when you have a comeback win in the first one and then you outright don't get behind in any scores in the second one, you're going to definitely go back to the first one and say that one's better. That's my opinion. So I definitely went to both Camellia Bowls, but I definitely thought Toledo was a great opponent, no offense to them. I thought Ohio and Appalachian State was a great matchup, and I just love what the game itself. And I just want to shout out the Camellia Bowl. I think they're one of the best bowl games I've ever been to. I love the fan experience. I just love everything about Camellia Bowl. And the fans and the people of Montgomery just are so loving to App and so loving to every team that comes there. I wish luck to anyone who goes there, and I'm just saying, it's going to be hard to win, but the fans there root for the home, root for the team that they know has good tradition, and they love rooting. So get ready if you're going to Camellia Bowl. It's a great experience. I can't explain how great it is. Number one, we all can guess this. If you didn't think hard enough, you're missing it. You've been thinking, like, where is this coming down the line? Where is this one at? Well, you finally get it. 2007, Michigan versus Appalachian State upset of all time. We're going to show you a quick highlight reel I made with David Jackson call, and I couldn't find this video with his voice on the field tape, so I actually had to make it myself, cut off audio off one of the films of him saying, Michigan has gone down, or something like that. I forget, it's just so gives me goosebumps, I can't remember. But I had to cut off the audio and paste it onto the film and line it up exactly. So, hope you enjoy this. But first, let's take a look. This score is 6 seconds left. Michigan down by 2, I believe. So, here we go.
7-yard field goal. This is it. This is it right here. Ginsel ready. The snap's good. The whole
block!
The kick's
good!
The kick is good! The Mountaineers are going to try to take
it's
it back to the big house!
Ginsel to the big house!
20! 15! The Mountaineers have just beaten the Michigan Wolverines! The Mountaineers of Appalachian State have just beaten the Michigan Wolverines in the big house!
Thank you for joining me, and I'm
so glad to announce the new JCU Sports Productions podcast coming out soon, and more videos coming out soon. I've been slowing down because sports, but I'm injured now, so I can start doing this a lot more. I love my studio. I love my way I do it. I'm going to high school, if I can find my thing right quick. I framed this because it's a big high school, one in the nation's top, like one in North Carolina's top high schools for scoring. Frame this, but this is my acceptance letter to the high school in my county, and it's actually one of the top scores in North Carolina, so I'm happy to be going there, and I'll be studying graphic design while I'm there. So just cheer me on, and hope this helped me get on my journey of going to high school and completing my graphic design, and going to App and completing my graphic design, so I can be a professional one and probably work for App and help App, because I love Appalachian State. And we'll be back later on today or tomorrow to talk about my artwork. My state-winning artwork, and my other artwork. So we'll get back. Thank you very much. And JCU Sports Productions, NC, thank you very much. Bye.